What's going on, guys? Geeks on the Fin. Today we're going to be reviewing the Zack Snyder's Justice League review, and this is actually my fourth time fucking recording this video, so maybe it'll work. And if you haven't watched the movie, then make sure you go check it out. You can watch on HBO Max, you can watch on Sky Cinema, stuff like that. So this review will actually be split into two parts, being this the first part, and then I don't know when the second part will be uploaded, but it will be uploaded at some point. So yeah, it starts off with a thank you from Zack Snyder himself at the start of it, and saying thank you fans for doing what you did, like fucking hashtag release a Snyder cut, WB got a load of crap, fucking just Whedon got a load of crap, literally everyone that was involved with the Joss Whedon Justice League got a load of crap just because it was so bad, and it was, we deserved the Zack Snyder's Justice League cut, and it fucking came out. And right from the start there was already new footage with Superman screaming. By that I mean like Superman was screaming, and then they sent out shockwaves going all the way to the Amazon's place where fucking Wonder Woman's from, and so that was kind of cool to see, because obviously Batman died. Batman, fucking hell, who am I on about? Superman died, Batman versus Superman, and that was by Doomsday, and it fucking hit Lois Lane, it hit Wonder Woman, it hit Batman, like as in by hit, I mean like it hit them personally, because like obviously Batman was like fucking fighting with it during that movie. Lois Lane was fucking hooking up with him, like she was his girlfriend, and Wonder Woman barely knew him, but it was kind of, she kind of fought beside him. So they were the people that are kind of fucking hit, like fucking was very touched by his death, and it was so sad, not gonna lie. You do get to see new footage of Lex Luthor seeing the mother boxes being put together. It's more like a vision, a premonition of what a premonition is, as some sort. Because it was, Lex Luthor wasn't like bold then, if that makes sense. He wasn't bold. And so you see new footage of him seeing the mother boxes, and you also see new dialogue. You get new dialogue from Ben Affleck with Aquaman. I am reading off the notes, by the way. You do get new dialogue from Ben Affleck with Aquaman, and it's literally just that same scene where Batman goes to see Aquaman, but instead of the lines that you got in that scene in the Joss Whedon movie, you get completely different lines. Like the lines in that whole scene are different, except for obviously we need your help, and yeah, people sang as Batman left from seeing Aquaman, and Aquaman goes underwater. Obviously Aquaman kind of, he goes underwater, he pretty much, he has the blood of Atlanteans, he doesn't really fit in and go and see his people, because he doesn't really like them. Well, I won't say he doesn't like them, he's just not really close with his Atlantean people, but he does go underwater and do what he needs to do under there. And Batman, I didn't really understand the people singing when Batman left. Yeah, if you want to tell me, then leave in the comments down below. There was a new scene with Bruce coming off a helicopter to meet Alfred. Seems more of a billionaire in this, in the Zack Snyder's Justice League, which is good, because obviously I can't remember if that was in the previous one, but I put it down just in case. I know that fucking in the Joss Whedon version, Batman kind of came off a little bit of a prick. I'm not saying it wasn't a prick, well, I am saying it was a prick, but he came off feeling like a little bit of a prick. And he seemed more of billionaire philanthropist in this fucking version of the Justice League movie, which is golden. It's great. So I like Batman's character more as well. I actually think fucking all of the characters improved. Like, this just proves that Zack Snyder was the better choice than fucking Joss Whedon. Like, Joss Whedon should never have stepped in. Never, ever, ever. The arrival of Steppenwolf is seen by others, when Steppenwolf comes in, it shows like this massive blue light beam when he's arriving, and there's only the people inside it that saw it, that were guarding the mother box. Like, from the previous version of the Justice League, I thought that it was just them that were guarding the mother boxes that saw Steppenwolf arrive. But clearly other people outside that bit were seeing the teleporter, him teleporting in. So it does make more sense, because obviously if you see a massive light beam coming from the sky, someone else is gonna notice. It's fucking quite stupid if they don't. The new look of Steppenwolf looks so better on the screen, and because his armor actually kind of is like, it's got spikes coming out, and it moves like it kind of moves on little in like a wave type thing all over his arms and his legs and shit. He moves in like a wave. It looks sick, so much better on screen. He looks so more menacing. His arrivals looked so more menacing, and I think that look choice. But listen, it was amazing. I'm telling you. Fucking the scene with this with Steppenwolf and the Amazons is longer. So the fight scene with the Amazons were longer. Like, just before we got the first mother box, it was actually longer. Like, them fighting each other was longer. It's just amazing. And as one of the bitches run out with the mother box before Steppenwolf gets it, of course, the thing shuts down and the whole building collapses. But Steppenwolf, being Steppenwolf, obviously escapes. It's like he's like some big mad villain. He's obviously going to escape when the thing collapses. And you see him again, and he's so much more badass, because you kind of get more of a clear view of him being in an area more bright. When he's out of that area, he was in the building that was collapsed, it was a more brighter, so you kind of saw a better look of Steppenwolf. This Zack Snyder Justice League, it's like a completely new thing. It's like, forget Joss Whedon's version. If you compare that to this, you can tell Zack Snyder's Justice League is like a completely new thing. There's new dialogue for Steppenwolf. Like, there's new dialogue for pretty much every single character that's in this movie. And obviously, the Arrow of Artemis. I feel like that bit was a bit different, because I think in the Joss Whedon's version, they only showed them like firing off the arrow to send the message. Didn't show the stuff before that, them showing the arrow in the box and then them giving it to Thingy, them lighting it and then firing it. They didn't show all that. They only show Thingy with it lighting and then firing it for Wonder Woman to see. Correct me if I'm wrong, obviously, if anything in this video. So Superman's ship was at Star Labs. I'm like, did they get that when Superman died or something? It's like studying or something, because if they did, that's wrong. The prophecy of Darkseid was seen. So obviously there's a Darkseid is from a planet called Apocalypse, and these are known to be like this badass villain. He can destroy planets, he can do a lot of shit with his Omega beams. I'm gonna go more and deep into the Omega beams later on. So Wonder Woman actually sees the prophecy of Darkseid and fucking sees that, yeah, this is coming true. This is what's going to happen, because the fucking arrow fits the thing, and she actually gets all the information of what's probably going to happen with Darkseid. When Steppenwolf kind of went back to put the first mother box in, he ended up talking to someone. I don't know if that was in a Joss Whedon's vision, but I just can't fucking remember who it was he was talking to. I do not think it was I don't think it was in the Joss Whedon's vision. I'm pretty sure it was a new thing. There was actually a quote in the movie called like saying like no lanterns, no Kryptonians. It's like obviously it showed like in the movie it did show a flashback of like fucking Darkseid being wrecking the whole place with man, Atlantean and the Amazonians like fighting against to stop Darkseid, and the lantern that was involved in that actually died and the ring flew off. And the no Kryptonians part was obviously Superman's dead at that point, so obviously that's why I said no lanterns, because the lantern that was involved in the previous Darkseid war thing died, and Superman also is dead in died in Batman versus Superman. And I did already mention the flashback of Darkseid, so I don't really need to say that, but he does look so fucking menacing, bro. Holy shit. I don't actually remember, but you see a little bit more action of the Green Lantern that was in it, and holy, it was good. Holy. I'm thinking that the Green Lantern's ring either went to Jon Stewart or it went to Hal. Because I know, like, whenever the wearer of the Green Lantern ring dies, the Green Lantern ring comes off and flies and goes wherever it chooses, because the ring has its own like will power thing, so it'll go to whoever is worthy, I guess, of the ring, and the person finds it, puts it on, boom, Green Lantern. So Darkseid's home planet Apokolips was mentioned. I've already mentioned that fucking Darkseid is a part of this like planet called Apokolips. It's not a very fucking good place if you've seen it in like, I think it's been in like animated movies of Justice League, like the DC animated movies of Justice League. It's been in there, and it's obviously been in Lego games. More specifically, it's been in Lego DC Supervillains. The Apokolips planet's been on that. Barry first seeing Iris was actually kind of good to see. Like, I knew it was going to happen because it was in the trailer, so it was kind of really good to see. And I think that when the Flashpoint movie comes out, Iris will return, so that's going to be amazing. If you hear any noise, I'm sorry about that. Barry is so fucking comical, Batman, and I actually love it. I do. I honestly do. Like, throughout the whole movie, Barry is the comical side of the whole movie, I think. Him and Aquaman were the comical side, in my opinion. Iris does get in the car. Iris gets in a car crash and Barry saves her, because obviously Barry has super speed. He's the Flash, yay, hell. Fucking... So Iris gets in the car and Barry saves her with super speed, and he ruins his shoes, because obviously if you run at super speed, his fucking shoes are going to catch on fire and get destroyed. So that happens, and when he does go to save her, music starts playing, like this romantic like type music starts playing, and obviously does make it romantic, and it shows they will in the future end up being together. They don't obviously straight away, but they will end up being together, because it's Iris. He don't know it's Iris, but it's Iris. New Lois Lane scene holding Superman's capes, because obviously Lois Lane is still mourning the death of Clark Kent, the death of Superman. So obviously Lois Lane is mourning her, and you see that with him, with Lois Lane holding his cape. Is something going on? Like when they had this scene when they was looking over like fucking, I think it was Flash's market scene where he kind of ran off the camera and ran back. I think they was watching that, and I can't actually remember what they were watching. I think it was, I know they was watching something to do with one of the members of the Justice League, but anyway, they kind of went to go do the same thing, and her hand went on top of Batman's, and I was kind of Bruce's. And I was out, my first thought was like, is something going on with Diana and Bruce? Because I was like, I'm 100% sure, not 100%, but I'm kind of sure that something did happen between Wonder Woman and Batman in the comics, and Wonder Woman and Superman and all that. Bruce, Batman and Wonder Woman. So I'm just fucking happy with those characters, with Bruce, Batman and Wonder Woman. They all were different. Like I said, every character in this version were different. You do see a flashback of Cyborg as a rugby or American football or wherever you're from player. His when he was a player, a sports player, rugby. He you actually get to see his accident as well. He gets in a car crash because his mother wasn't paying attention at the road and it fucks him up. New scene with Cyborg testing his abilities out. I don't actually know if that was a new scene thinking about it, but it seemed different, so I put it down. He fucking Cyborg making a person's life more easier. Like, it's obviously nice to see with the shit. Nice to see shit when they're using it. They're, when they just find out their abilities and they're testing it out on, like, civilians to make their life easier. For example, Cyborg gave hacked into their bank thing and gave the person more money because she was low on money and didn't really have a job. She was going poor, pretty much. So Cyborg made her life easier. Cyborg seems to be massively important, which he was, and he wasn't just Whedon's, but he is more important in this one. Barring his father, Henry Allen, Harry Allen had a heartfelt scene when, because obviously Barry's mum died, and couldn't explain what it was, so Henry is Barry's father, got in prison for it, which is so upsetting. I was like, damn, why did you have to do me like that? Barry was acting dumb, even though there is a tech suit for his speeds, because right, basically in the scene there was a version of Batman came in to see Barry, and obviously is just like, he's talking to him, he's saying, I hear you're special, and Bruce doesn't believe what Barry's saying when he's acting dumb and throws a fucking batarang. And that bit when he throws a batarang and Barry goes looking to see what he threw at with his super speed, that's longer. Yeah, like I said, him catching the batarang, that's longer. And when Steppenwolf goes for the mother box in Atlantis, Aquaman goes and saves Mira from Steppenwolf. If you didn't know, Aquaman and Mira actually date in the comics, so yeah. This is going to conclude part one of the Zack Snyder's Justice League review. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Smash like, give a video, subscribe if you're new. To post notifications on for more to see part two of the Zack Snyder's Justice League review. And I'll see you lovely people in the next one. Goodbye. We'll